Hi there, this is Steve Chen. Today we are going to learn about how to use the 5069 serial module from Allen Bradley. If you cannot find a useful example online, don't worry. I will show you how to use this module and offer you a link to download my sample code. Let's check it out. So this is the 5069 serial module that we are going to discuss today. You can download its user manual online. And please keep in mind that this module has to be installed as a local input-output module, which means on the same rack with the CompactLogic 5000 series controller. And this is the laser displacement sensor manufactured by Panasonic. It's a very compact sensor, you can hold it in one hand. We are going to use this one in our example. Now let's take a look at the sensor's communication specifications. This sensor supports either RS-422 or RS-485. And you can see that I put a red box on the screen. That's because these parameters are critical when we implement our PLC program. This is how I connect the wires to the modules in my example because I'm going to use more than one sensor in my application, so I choose to use RS-485. If you are only using one sensor on your network, you can choose to use RS-422. Here is the string that we are going to send out in our example. You can see that the string starts with a start delimiter and ends with a termination delimiter. In the middle is the destination number. If I have 10 sensors, then the destination number will be from 01 to 10. So it depends on which sensor you want to talk to. You have to put the corresponding destination number in your string. In the command here, you can specify what kind of information you want to ask the sensor for. You can ask for the current measurement data or the data in the buffer, or the working status of the sensor. And the command here is followed by the BCC. BCC stands for block check character. It's used for error detection. And the CR stands for carriage return. It's like saying that, okay, this is the end of the string. And this is how we calculate the block check character, because I don't think Rockwell Automation supports or provides this kind of function in their PLC program. So you have to calculate these characters for yourself. So in my example, we're going to ask for data from the first sensor. I'm going to put our destination number as 01. And this is a start delimiter, as you know. So start delimiter and the 01 is the destination number, and RMD means that we want to read the current measurement value, and the BCC here is going to be 5C. So if you change the destination number to 02, 03, or 12, that your BCC is going to be different. Please keep that in mind. If a sensor is on the network and we put in the right destination number, it's going to send us a response that also starts with a start delimiter followed by a sender number, and that number should be the same as your destination number in your request. So in my example, it's going to be 01 because we asked 01, hey, what's your data right now? So it should send us a response saying, okay, this is 01 and my data is blah, blah, blah. And in their user manual, they ask for data from the third sensor instead, but you know the idea. So let's take a look at how we implement all the configurations in the program. When you double-click the module in your program, you will open this Module Properties tab. Sometimes when you purchase module from Allen Bradley or Rockwell Automation, you may not have the latest version of firmware. You can use Control Flash to update that to the latest version. I always suggest people update the firmware and software to the latest version because they fix some bugs, even though I know some people don't like it. And depends on your application, you can choose different kinds of communication protocols on channel 0 and channel 1. You can use Modbus Master or Modbus Slave or DF1. Because our sensor only supports generic ASCII, I will set the two channels into generic ASCII here. Then let's take a look at channel 0. As I mentioned before, the information in the red box is critical because we are going to implement that on the properties page here. So the baud rate is 38,400 bits per second, and the data bits, parity, and the stop bit have to fit the specs as well. And the serial media is RS-485 for sure. All these parameters have to be exactly as the specifications that we just see. If they are not the same, your communication is going to be messed up. Now let's take a look at the ASCII table. The reason we look at this ASCII table is that we have to convert the start delimiter and the termination delimiter into hex format, and I highlighted both of them in red box as well. you can see for the carriage return, which is the termination delimiter, is converted into 0D, and the start delimiter becomes 25. So on your properties page, you have to put 25 into your start delimiter box, and put 0D into your termination delimiter box. By the way, you can change your start mode and termination mode to something else. I think the default is ignore. If I ignore my delimiters, then my data will come in like a new sticker. It won't split the data into smaller packets. It's messy. So please keep this in mind if you're using the same sensor or communication setup. If your data becomes a new sticker, that is probably because you did not include your start delimiter and your termination delimiter. And it's the same for the transmit here. You may notice that I put FF in the second termination delimiter, and that is because I only used the first one. You can look up the user manual for more detail, but I'm not going to discuss too much of them here. Now let's jump into the PLC program. In the first run, I used the system first scan to initialize the program, reset the transmit ID and the receive ID, clean the buffer and set my sampling period to 1000 milliseconds. And this is how I set up my string. I don't think you can input your string into your PLC program in another approach. And I add a note here. Please include the start delimiter and termination delimiter in your string, because in the earlier slides, we include the start delimiter and termination delimiter. If you did not put them into your string, and you ask your system to look for them, your communication is going to be a mess again. On the second run, I ask the sensor for data once the timer is done. It's basically like asking for it every single second. So I ask for data and the sensor gives a response. And another second later, I'm going to ask for data again. And the other second later, I'm going to ask for data again. It just repeats itself until I turn off the controller. So once I get a string from the sensor, I'm going to turn it into a double integer, then convert that into a real number and display it on my HMI. But I won't discuss anything about HMI in this video. If you're interested in how to do that, just comment below. The last part is an alarm that I created for this module. Because there's no single bit in this module that reports to you if the sensor doesn't give any response. However, the indicator on the module will indicate that it does not receive a response from your sensor. But interestingly, you cannot get that data bit from your module. It's just for the indicator. So here I create a little trick. Once the sensor doesn't give us any response three times in a row, then we are going to reset the HMI value to zero and probably going to trigger an alarm on your system. Or else you can set it to a very, very large number, depends on how you use your sensor. So let's take a look at how it works. First, click offline and then go online. If you are passing a program from your computer to your controller, choose download. In contrast, choose upload to retrieve a program from your controller. Now switching from programming mode to run mode. You can see the sensor's reading here after going through a series of data type conversions. Also, the transmit ID and receive ID are changing with every data request and response every second. If you need a shorter sampling period and more frequent data response, we can set it to 100 milliseconds. Now the reading updates will be more frequent. Lastly, if you prefer reading articles, you can search this article or my profile on LinkedIn. I've written 7 technical articles already, and I will continue to publish my research results. Before you close your browser, let me remind you that you can download my sample code on GitHub. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below and share this video with your friends. Have a nice day.